Welcome to Love Fellowship Believers, a non-denominational church desiring to fulfill God's will. We invite you to join us in an atmosphere of praise and worship and the powerful teachings of Christ delivered in a most creative way that reaches every age. Located at 1900 Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard in Greensboro, North Carolina, on the wonderful campus of Gillespie Park Elementary School. This year, we're focusing on building a foundation solidified by grace, with walls made by faith, and our homes being filled with salvation by being united in living devotion. We promise you, visiting us online or in the sanctuary will be an experience that will be life-changing and one you'll never forget. We hope to see you soon. Services begin at 11 a.m. Have a blessed day.
That type of God in your life, you've seen him to be awesome, to show up in areas that you didn't know how you was going to make it out of. You didn't even know that danger was lurking on you, and your God showed up yet to still be awesome. Come on, can we give God a hand praise? Amen, amen. Amen, amen, amen. This morning's scripture will be coming from Luke chapter 3. We read verses 1 through 6. Earlier, for our responsive reading, we'll be concentrating on verse 4, 5, and 6. Luke chapter 3, verses 4, 5, and 6.
Easy more time to get there. We'll hold on. If not, if I'm ready, I'll go ahead and read. Amen.
Man, I still see a few people flipping. Amen. Amen. Are we ready? It says, as it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. Every valley shall be filled, every mountain and every hill shall be brought low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough ways shall be made smooth. Verse 6, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. Let us pray. Father God, first and foremost, we say thank you. Again, God, thanking you for a time such as this. Lord, it's preaching time, God, and we ask that your word would be shared the way that you would have it to be done, God. So I ask that you would direct my mouth to move the way and say the things that you would have for me to say this morning, God. Open up ears and hearts and minds that we would be receptive to what thus saith the Lord. Help us, Father God, to be better and to do better in all that we do for you. For it's in the wonderful name of Jesus that we do pray. Amen, amen, and amen, amen. You may be seated. If you're choosing to take notes today, if you're choosing to write down a title, it would be simple. Prepare the way. Prepare the way. Prepare the way. Amen, amen, amen. I was so anxious to wear my t-shirt this morning that I missed out on it being the first Sunday. Amen. So I had to do a little wardrobe change. We thank the Lord. Amen? Amen. Amen. Prepare the way. Prepare the way. Anybody ever read this in Scripture before? The Scripture that we're going through today. Anybody ever read this before? If you would call yourself any type of Bible scholar or someone that studies the Word or whatever, through these Gospels, you should have come across something similar to this right here. This right here is talking about a young man who was known to be the forerunner of Christ. A young man who was known that his specific purpose in life was to do just that. Prepare ye the way. We're talking about John the Baptist. And although John the Baptist talked about the repentance from your sins, he could not give salvation. He could not give salvation. But he did say, look, there's one that's coming after me, whose shoelaces I'm even unworthy to tie. If you go through scripture and you read, you'll find that. But what I want to talk about today is I want to put a 2017 twist on this scripture. As it is written in the book of Isaiah the prophet, now I know that's spelled a little bit different, but if you have your Bibles and you want to write down in your notes, you'll find the words written over in Isaiah chapter 40. In Isaiah chapter 40, you'll find how this was originally written. Saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness. Well, this voice of the one crying in the wilderness, you'll find out if you go back up to verse number 2, you'll find out that it's John, the son of Zacharias in the wilderness. Crying in the wilderness. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make his path straight. Biblical history shows that even in the same place that John was, it's the same place that Isaiah was in the Old Testament. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make his paths straight. The 2017 twist of this is just that. What are you doing? Here's my question. What are you doing to prepare the way? What are you doing to prepare the way? For folk that God puts in your life, for folk that cross your path, what are you doing to prepare the way? In the Old Testament, what they were talking about when they, what would happen is that if a king was traveling, you know, he didn't get a plane, he didn't get an Uber, he didn't do any of that kind of stuff. They had to actually walk, or they actually had to ride animals to wherever they was going. And wherever they had to take with them, you know, the buggies, the horse, or whatever, and even sometimes folk being carried is how they went from one place to another. And what they would do is they would have folk that would go out in front of them. Brother Larry, what they would do is that they would do just that. They would prepare the way. If you look at the scripture here, you'll see here, it says that every valley shall be filled. And so if there was a low spot, they would put something in it to make it even high. Every mountain and hill shall be brought down. If there was a mountain or something in a hill or something in the way, they would chop that down to make it smooth. The crooked shall be made straight. If there was a path that took them another way, no, they straightened it all out. All so that the king would have an easy path to wherever he was going. Are y'all following me? And so I asked the question again in 2017, what are you doing to prepare the way of the Lord? What are you doing for your coworkers? What are you doing for your friends? What are you doing for your family that it would be easier for them to accept Christ into their life? What are you doing? Are you living a life that you talk about? Are you even talking about Jesus to someone? Are you even sharing? Are you praying for one another? Are you loving on one another? Are you forgiving each other? What are you doing to prepare the way? You might not have to fill in a valley. You might not have to physically tear down a hill or to make something crooked straight. You might not physically have to do that. But spiritually, what are you doing to prepare the way? Scripture says that we must worship him in spirit and in truth. What are you doing to prepare the way? As we look at this, we see that there's a lot of work that goes into that, a lot of different things that goes on, because as the story goes on, this John the Baptist, this is exactly what he was doing. He was in the wilderness. He was telling folk, you're going to have to repent of your sins. There's one coming. There's one coming. There's one coming. And if you don't know the whole story of John the Baptist, you'll come to find out that John the Baptist, after Jesus came, ended up going through a whole lot. Ended up eventually losing his life, being persecuted for what it is that he's doing. And so by reading that and applying that to 2017, that lets me know that even as being a spokesperson for Christ, even as being one that would prepare the way, because just as John did not have the ability to save anybody's life, neither one of us have the ability to save anybody else's life. We can only do what John did, and that's point them to Jesus. Point them to Jesus. What are you doing to point somebody else to Christ? If someone was to spend any amount of time with you, would they know that Jesus is real? If anybody was to hang out with you for a little while, if anybody was to follow you for a day, would they know that how much Jesus really means to you in your life? Would your actions and your responses line up with wanting somebody, with having somebody to want to know more about this man named Jesus? Prepare ye the way. And so as it goes on and it talks about all the different things, now we see here that the last part of verse number 5 says, and the rough ways shall be made smooth. Shall be made smooth. I've seen a lot of people try to introduce Jesus to other folk. Unfortunately, some of the ways that folk have tried to do that, I personally didn't think it was the right way. This is normally how it goes sometimes. Mika, this is what they'll do. They'll go and they'll want to point out everything that's wrong, everything that's messed up, and then say, you need to get right, and you need to follow Jesus. Anybody ever had that experience before? Anybody ever seen that? I mean, to the person that's a drunk, they'll go ahead and they'll beat them up over how much they drink and whatever they're involved in. To the person that's dealing with homosexuality or lesbianism or anything else, they'll beat the person up over whatever their issue is and then try to get them to follow Christ. My wife and I, we hadn't been to Asheville in quite some time. You might have heard me tell this story before. We were in Asheville, and as we were there in Asheville, there was this guy, and he was trying to tell folk about Jesus. But in trying to tell folk about Jesus, he was saying it in such a hateful way. It's true, that if we don't accept Christ, that hell will be our home. It's true. But if I want to be a spokesman for Christ, then hatred shouldn't be spewed out of my mouth. What I should actually try to do is to try to get you to listen to what I'm saying. What I should try to do is to say something that's going to get your attention. But if you're doing something wrong, I know you're doing something wrong. You know you're doing something wrong. Eddie, what's the sense of me continuing to go on and go on when I can simply say that in spite of what you got going on, God loves you anyhow, and he can deliver you from that. He's willing to work with you on that if you're willing to work with him. Scripture says that we are to lift up the name of Jesus. He will call all men unto him. But what happens is a lot of times is that people start pointing fingers. My daughters, my youngest daughter in particular, Lindsay, she's 13. So she's at the age of a 13-year-old where they get pimples. They get pimples. And so my daughter is very conscious about having pimples. It's something that we've all gone through. It's something that there's even folk that people have adult acne and they have skin and do all this. What good would it do for me to sit there and point out every single pimple that she has? That's not going to help her. I see the pimple. She know that the pimple's there. What I should be willing to do is to say, look, I've gone through what you've gone through. Let me tell you what it is that you need to do to go ahead and help to clean that up. Now, if she chooses to listen to me, that's fine. But if she chooses not to listen to me and wants to do it her own way, same exact way when we're talking to somebody about Christ. We ought to be willing to say something to somebody in love that someone would want. What are you doing to prepare the way? What is going on in your life that would have somebody to want to say, what must I do to be saved? Tell me more about this man named Jesus. What is going on? What am I missing? What is it that I haven't gotten yet? Is it a mountain in my way? Well, if there's a mountain, help me tear this mountain down so my way will be made straight. If there's a valley in my way, help me to fill in this hole so that I can get it. Prepare either way. With John being in the wilderness, talking about the remission of sins, how much more easier do you think it was for the followers of John to now be able to follow Jesus? Now when he comes, yeah, the remission of sins, but now there's salvation that comes after that. Verse 6 says, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. It doesn't say that we were to make it, that we were to make it, that we had to do it. It said that all flesh would see the salvation of God. How would they see? Based upon how you have prepared the way. Again, my question goes to each and every single person here and listening on our radio. What are you doing to prepare the way? If we want this world to change, if we want to see things differently, we got to respond differently. We can't respond the way everybody else responds. We can't do the things that everybody else does. It's not about trying to follow a law or not trying to follow a law. It's about simply doing what's right. It's about simply being concerned about my Father's business more than I am about my own. This was John the Baptist. John the Baptist didn't have any big fancy house. John the Baptist didn't have all of these other things that folk might be concerned about. John the Baptist simply, it says that he was crying out in the wilderness, preaching and teaching the remission of sins. There's somebody coming, y'all. Get ready. I want to echo those same sentiments of John the Baptist today. There's somebody coming, y'all. With every second that goes by, it's closer to his time. Scripture says that there will be a trump that'll sound. And all that are dead in Christ will be those that arise up first. But yet those which remain will be caught up in the air with him. He's coming, y'all. He's coming. How sad a day it would be that Christ would come and to find out that somebody that you spent just about every day with, somebody that you say that you love, wouldn't be counted in the number. How sad it would be to find out that God had chosen you as the vessel to prepare the way for your loved one. But instead, you know how we treat folk that we love? We'll be just as kind to the stranger in the line in the grocery store. But the one that we love, sometimes we'll talk to them any old kind of way. Well, Pastor, they just don't get it. You don't understand. I've tried this and I've tried that. That's wonderful. Try something different. How sad it would be to find out that God had chosen you as to be the vessel to save your family. But you weren't willing to prepare the way. Do you see what it takes to prepare the way? They said you filling in valleys. They didn't say you was filling in a ditch. They said you were filling in valleys. They said moving mountains. It's not easy. But it's what we've been called to do. Again, I want to share with you today scripture coming from the book of Luke, chapter 3. As John was one that prepared the way for Jesus, as he was a forerunner for Jesus. John's done his job. John has gone on. Jesus still reigns as king. We are required to lift up the name of Jesus. Amen. One last thing, and we'll get ready to close. I was thoroughly surprised this week. It caught me totally off guard. At my job, I've shared with you sometimes some of the things that I've gone through and some of the things that happened. And my boss at my job, we had an interesting conversation this week. He's been there probably a couple of years now, and we haven't always seen eye to eye. And I've had no problem in voicing my opinion about how I felt about that. Amen. This week, he called me into his office and we started to have a conversation. We started to talk about the Bible. He says, Now, Kevin, he says, I know you're preaching everything. He said, but I'm not saying that I'm an atheist, but I ain't saying I'm a believer. He says, but I got a neighbor who came over and they're always talking about this Bible. And so what we're doing is that they come over every weekend and we sit in the garage and we go through the Bible chapter by chapter. I think he said he was in the 30th chapter of Genesis. And so he came and he said, well, they've answered some questions and all that. He said, but I still got some questions. Got some questions for you. And so he gave me his questions. And one of the questions, I was like, you're going to have to ask God on that one. I don't know. You're going to have to ask God. He said, I appreciate that. You didn't just make up something and try to tell me, or you didn't tell me what you believe. He said, I appreciate that. And he asked me a couple of other questions, and we had some conversation. It's just a wonderful thing to see. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing to see. Amen. I've called out his name several times here in prayer for some different health issues and things that he's gone through. But just praise God for whatever situation, for whatever he's allowed to happen, to call somebody to think differently. And I want to encourage you, no matter who that loved one is, no matter who that coworker is, no matter whoever it is in your life that you've been praying and you've been hoping that they one day find out and get to know Jesus for themselves, I want to encourage you to just keep preparing the way. Whatever it is you got to do, keep preparing the way. If you need to just continue to pray, keep preparing the way. If your actions need to speak louder than you, keep preparing the way. If folk want to look at you and say, you know, you don't talk like you used to talk, you don't dress like you used to, you don't do like you used to do, keep preparing the way. The biggest thing is not going to be your shovel. The biggest thing is not going to be the tool that you have in your hand. The biggest thing is that you're going to show whoever it is love. And watch God do the rest. Amen? Amen. Come on, let's put our hands together for the Lord. Prepare ye the way. Amen? Amen.